was fantastic. The Miss Marguerite and the vampire, you know, I just thought it was a wonderful kind of starting point, something kind of to go quite wacky.
It was like, you know, being a schoolgirl on acid. It was like all your kind of most wicked fantasies about that age group there it was.
I love the sort of backless idea, the theme that kept running through, the backless theme. I think backless is always elegant, whether it's a long dress or a short dress.
The textiles, those, the printing of the textiles, some of those I would kill for.
Why are you smiling at me?
I loved the corsetry. I loved the whole idea of like the big ties and the corsets at the beginning. I thought that was really exciting and very flattering.
English Eccentrics is very clever in that I think it sums up what is really good about the British, and that is eccentricity, teapots, teacups, cakes. With Helen's designs, she manages to invert them, so there is a sense of eccentricity and slight madness as well. Beautiful clothes. I'm mad about the pink one with the short skirt. Because the legs are all I've got left, darling, so I'm definitely going to be strutting my stuff in that one.
At the beginning there were prints, the clock prints, the bird cages, all the silk kind of printing. I love that.
When I awoke, there was a curious icy draught in my room and an unfamiliar smell of earth. Despite my fiancé's stringent warnings, I'd left the bedroom window open. It was then that I realized I had two small wounds on my neck, each one a deep ruby red. The wounds did not heal. Something had entered my room. Come back. accompanied by a flapping sound and an eerie, icy feeling of extreme evil. What does this strange vision mean? Who or what was that evil apparition? Why do I have no appetite and desire? Let me tell you this. It is out of the lore and experience of the ancients and of all those who have studied the powers of the undead. Circle goes on ever widening, like as the ripples from a stone thrown in the water. Nosferatu. Nosferatu.